I'm Austin Davenport, and we're here at the Deep Roots Community Garden, and today I'm going to show you how to grow microgreens. Now, microgreens are perfect for any range of skill levels or gardening space. These vegetables grow in small condensed containers and are typically harvested within 10 to 14 days. You can see here that I'm growing these microgreens in a 10-inch by 20-inch nursery tray. These trays are easy to come by, and I like them personally because I can expect about a pound of greens from a single tray. In order to sterilize the tray, I just use a bit of soap and water, but also any sort of like bleach solution will work as long as you wipe it back down and get it nice and dry before you use it. But before putting in any growing media, I like to create a little wicking system using twine, and that'll hang into a reservoir of water and bring water up to the trays as needed. I'll show you how this works. So the twine pulls up the water to the plants just as needed. Not too much water, not too little, but just right. Starting out, you'll want to use a nice clean growing container. And some growing media. I like to use coconut coir personally because it's inert and it doesn't have any sort of fungus gnats or microbes. I could put this whole tray into the fridge without having to worry about introducing any sort of dirt and contamination to my fridge. You want your growing media to be nice and damp, about a ringed out sponge level of dampness, before you set it down into the tray, and that'll help get perfect germination every time. Microgreen seeds are anything that are like a vegetable that you could eat the entire plant, stem, leaf, all of it. That mostly includes all your leafy greens, your peas, your cabbages, your bok choys, your brassicas, lentils. I like radish most specifically because it's nice and spicy at the end. It's not too spicy, but with other microgreens, I think it gives a really, really good balance. And now I'm just gently spreading the seeds. I just want good, clean coverage. I want some touching. I don't want them on top of each other, just one single layer. And then I'm really gonna go in hard on the edges because the edges will keep everything nice and straight. And from here, we're just gonna give the seeds a good little watering. Dang it. The rosette on this thing is a little clogged. We don't wanna disturb the soil level so much. We wanna keep everything nice and even. From here, we're gonna check on the seeds at least once a day to make sure there's good germination, nice and damp surface. And we're also gonna put another tray on top of it just to keep out all the light. We want the seeds to grow devoid of any light, and that will help them grow straight upwards. After a few days of where we see good germination and straight yellow seedlings, we'll move these to a light source. That can be a windowsill, that can be fluorescent lights. Any light source will do as long as it's like T5, natural lighting, or LEDs. These have been under darkness for about 2 to 3 days now. I've kept it nice and damp. We have really good germination. I want to see about maybe 1.25 inches of them nice and straight upwards before I'll start moving them to a light source. I could definitely move these to a light source now and it would work out just fine, but I want them just a little bit more straight for my personal preference. I'll gently water these from the top using a small watering can or a spray bottle. I want the roots to start getting a little bit longer before I switch to the bottom watering method. These are about 4 days old. At about 5 to 6 days old, the roots will be long enough for me to use the bottom watering method. We want to use the bottom watering method for two main reasons. The first being to discourage any sort of fungus development on the surface. We want to water from the bottom up, not the top down, to try to keep the surface as dry as possible. And that'll help prevent any sort of molds developing on your microgreens. And we also want to have good air circulation in the room with these, and that'll help prevent any sort of molds developing on the top. When it comes time to harvest, you want to use a really, really sharp utensil. Otherwise, you'll start to see some browning from the bottoms, and that'll sort of reduce the shelf life. And that's it. After about 10 to 14 days, you're ready to harvest food that you grew yourself. These greens are incredibly delicious. They'll last you quite a long time, a lot longer than a packet of salad mix from the store. And thank you so much for your interest in growing a portion of your own food. Have fun.